Hey everyone, welcome back to another Python programming video. We're still looking at Python challenge. We're now on the 8th challenge. We just got finished up with the last one, number 7, oxygen. We moved on to integrity. So right in front of us, staring us in the face, is this bee. There is a scroll bar, so there is more to this page. And the only hint that we get here is down at the bottom. Where is the missing link? Alright. So, let's do some investigation. As always, I'm going to right-click this and view the page source. And here we go. Okay, title is Working Hard. Same CSS page we've always seen. There's an image, integrity.jpg. Oh, it has a map. Okay. Map. Area. Shape. So, that brings us to good.html. Can we go there? Can we just go? Where's the missing link? And unpw. This comment down here. Kind of wonder what all this is. I'm kind of curious what the map is, though. I'm gonna go to that one first. Oh, I want to go to return good.html. Let's go there. Go open my URL bar. Return good.html. Hey. Username and password are being requested by the page. The site says inflate. Username and password. Guest. No password. Admin. No password. Administrator. Not password. Okay, that didn't help. Oh! Not allowed to go there. That's the same thing that the map will take us to, right? So, alright, I notice if I move my cursor around the image, if I get on the B, if I click the B, okay, yeah, it takes me to that same authentication thing. UNPW. No. Okay, if we go look at the page source one more time, this UN and this PW must represent username and password. That makes sense. So I'll copy these and bring them in. How about that? I don't know why these would be username and password, but I mean, let's try it. Because this looks like random raw data. Nope, that didn't work either. Okay. Username and password are being requested by Python Challenge. The site says inflate. What is inflate? I don't know what that means. Well, we're using Python, so let's do some research. I'm gonna create a new tab. I'm gonna Google Python inflate. I'm feeling lucky, so let's go to the first result. Python inflate and deflate implementation. I know that Python includes. Know that Python includes zlib and the C libraries and Hang on, if I hit the back button. Okay, yeah, zlib is a return result in Google. I'm gonna look at the documentation here. Compression compatible with gzip. What? Okay, so do we have to this raw data here? Do we have to inflate it? It's gotta be what the hint is. Compress. I'm gonna look to this inflate on this page. There is no inflate function. No speaking of inflate. If I go back to this Stack Overflow page, he's using this decompress function. Alright, let's try it. I'm just gonna fire up idle and play with it in here because. We're just playing. Import zlib. Let's grab this username here. I'm just gonna copy and paste that. zlib.decompress. That's the function he used, right? zlib.decompress. And he's passing in a string of some kind, so decompress, paste in the string. Error, -3 while decompressing data. Incorrect header check. Okay. I don't know what that means either. Oh, he gets the same error. I received the following error. Error, -3. Incorrect header check. Gzip doesn't work either. What did these guys tell him? Oh, wait. He says he solved it. Okay, solved. To handle raw deflate and inflate data without the header and checksum. Okay, if we're getting an incorrect header check, I guess we don't need the header. Strip the first two bytes. Yeah, the following things need to happen. Strip the first two bytes and the last four bytes to checksum. Oh, okay. I don't know which of these are. Here. Decompress. Okay, strip the first two. Last four. These are escaped. I think this. 1, 2, 3. This would be 4. And there's another thing that needs to happen. There's a second argument. Oh, that's deflate income. Strip the first two bytes header and the last four bytes checksum. Okay. So we don't have to do that if we're inflating. On inflate, which is, I think, what we're doing, since, I mean, that's what it said on the page. Site says inflate, whatever that means. Damn it, go back. All right. There's a second argument for window size. If the value is negative, it suppresses headers. Okay, so arguments, -1. No. While preparing to decompress data, inconsistent stream state. I don't know what that means. Damn it. Okay. Let's just do a little bit more reading. What did this guy say down at the bottom? C sharp. Deflate streams. Java. Okay. All right. I think I'm getting into no man's land up here. More information. The first two bytes of the .NET deflate data. After B64 decoding, does not correspond to gzip data, and bzip2 data, or zlib data. Okay, well, we're working with zlib. Gzip, it said, didn't work for him either. What is bzip? What is bzip2? I remember when we removed the, or at least when I was thinking of removing, the first two bytes, it says bz up here. I wonder, okay, that could just be like pure coincidence, but I wonder if that has anything to do with bzip. Bzip2. I'm going to create a new tab and just research that. Python bzip2. Hey, alright, there's a module for it. Compression compatible with bzip2 in Python. Decompression of files. Hey, that's the same like thing we were doing with ours when we were trying to inflate. So, okay, I'm gonna go back to it. And decompression of files. Is there an inflate function? If I control F for that, no, there is not. But whoa, it brought me down to the bottom of the page, and there is a decompress function. Let's do it. I mean, let's just try it. Decompress data in one shot. If you want to decompress data sequentially, use an instance of bz2 decompressor instead. I think this function just might do it though. Alright. Back to idle. Import, what is this module called? BZ2? BZ2. Import BZ2. BZ2.decompress. Pass in the string. Oh, okay. Alright. We get a string. Huge. Whatever that means. Well, that's gotta be, that was the, what section? That was the username, right? So now we need the password. PW. I'm going to copy and paste this guy. If I run bz2 decompress. Oh, didn't need those extra quotes. Huge file. Okay. So username is huge. Password is file. Hey! Alright, awesome. Challenge number 9. We did it. Dude, that wasn't that bad. I'm kind of curious what more stuff BZ2 can do now. It's a comprehensive interface for the BZ2 compression library. Implements a complete file interface, one-shot decompression functions, and types for sequential decompression. Man, I'm very curious. I'll have to read and learn a little bit more about this. Okay, the purpose of the video is done. I mean, we're done. We got to the next challenge. So, let's see. Well, we didn't have to write any, like, real code in a text editor for this. We just kind of worked in idle. So now we got a little Christmas tree of strings and errors, but... Well, hey, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this one. I know it was a little bit of a different, kind of poking around, trial and error thing, but... Well, I mean, it works. So, again, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.